In this graph, we want to look at autoregulation of both renal blood flow and glomerular filtration rate. And what this means is that the kidney possesses intrinsic mechanisms to make sure that renal blood flow and GFR remain relatively stable over a very broad range of arterial blood pressures shown down here on our x-axis. We have flow on our y-axis, right? So our renal blood flow in the red line, and our GFR in the dashed blue line. We're going to focus a little bit more on the GFR than the renal blood flow, although both are important. Now, remember, GFR is essential to maintaining the production of urine. And so we have to produce a filtrate, a very large filtrate, and then we modify that through reabsorption and secretion to generate the urine. Now, GFR, we've got a sort of a schematic of our afferent arteriole leading blood flow in, our efferent arteriole blood flow out, the ball here in the center being the glomerulus, G for glomerulus, and PC is the capillary hydrostatic pressure that's tending to dominate and drive the production of our filtrate. Now, PC, this blood hydrostatic pressure, is regulated through the adjustments to afferent and efferent resistances through constriction and dilation. And so if we were to have a normal blood pressure, we would end up with GFR at about 125 milliliters per minute. However, if we were to tend towards a more hypertensive state, shift toward the right here, what would tend to happen is PC would rise. Now, in response to that rise in driving pressure, the afferent arteriole especially is going to undergo a myogenic reflex. And that what that means is that the smooth muscle in the wall of the afferent arteriole, in response to increased distension due to that higher pressure, is going to constrict. And so we see this transition toward a smaller diameter afferent arteriole. What's going to also happen is that the efferent arteriole, through separate mechanisms, is going to actually dilate. And so we're going to end up restricting our inflow, therefore dropping our capillary hydrostatic pressure. Remember, the pressure rose when the blood pressure went up, but we're going to constrict the afferent to cause this PC to come back down and allow us to maintain a relatively stable GFR, even though blood pressure rises and rises. This is a very potent mechanism. You can see we can have average blood pressures up to about 170 millimeters of mercury with almost no change in GFR. We can also drop down to about 70, a mean of 70 in our mean arterial pressure, and still maintain GFR. This is really important. This means different people with different blood pressures or the same person under different physiological conditions can maintain their renal function. Now, there is another mechanism of autoregulation, and it's called tubuloglomerular feedback. We'll see a bit more of this in a subsequent figure, but essentially what happens is if blood pressure were to fall, let's go this way, if blood pressure were to fall, that would cause PC to fall and GFR to fall, right? PC is our driving force for GFR to be produced, or filtration to be produced. And the flow rate along the nephron would decrease. The transporters in the nephron operate at essentially a fixed rate. And so if the flow through the nephron is slower, we would actually end up enhancing reabsorption. There'd be more time to reabsorb solutes as the tubular fluid flows along the nephron. Well, this is sensed at the macula densa, a portion of the nephron that feeds back to the vascular pole, these two blood vessels, the afferent and efferent. And so if GFR were to fall, we would decrease the osmolarity of the tubular fluid due to increased reabsorption, more time for reabsorption. That's sensed by these macula densa cells that then give a signal to the afferent arteriole to dilate, increasing PC, increasing GFR, and bringing us back to normal. The last thing we want to point out here is that this line, even though it looks like it's really well autoregulated, it's almost flat, it does have a slightly positive slope. So as pressure goes up, it does go up a little bit. This is actually adventitious, as we would have a need for enhanced excretion of volume in response to this rising blood pressure, helping to bring that pressure back down.